Thank you. They're able to circle up and see for all people, you know, everyone held hands, was able to share a moment together, just hurting. This is immediately after, you know, everyone saw the video of that 12-year-old getting shot. Everyone knew Tamir's name. Tamir was on the lips of everybody. And something needed to be done about it. People were able to make a circle down the student center. That second demonstration, you know, we had instructions. We were kind of getting more organized at that point. You know, the Black Studies Department kind of became that fusion center. People came, had instruction. And everybody knew that we were going to march, we were going to have a banner, and we were going to say, hands up, don't shoot. And when don't shoot happened, we were going to have a dying. So what we did was we were able to walk into the student center, kind of take control of the terrain, you know, we kind of mingled. We wanted to make our presence known. We were able to mingle and kind of walk around. Janitha was up there, and she held a banner, and when she hollers, hands up, and everyone responded, don't shoot. We fell on the floor and we made that point. Made it very, very difficult. Did you need some? What did you do?
Hands up, don't shoot! No justice, no peace.
And then Renee.
This is a list of unarmed men, women, and children shot by the police. I remind you, these people were unarmed. Kajin Powell, 25, St. Louis, Missouri, August 19, 2014, killed in a dark stairwell, unarmed. Azel Ford, 25, Los Angeles, California, killed because police said he tried to attack them with a knife. There was no knife found on the scene. Hands up, don't shoot. Dante Parker, 36, San Bernardino, California. Police responded to attempted break-in. Before they asked his name, they shot him unarmed.
No justice, no peace.
John Crawford, 22, Beer Creek, Ohio, carrying a colored gun in Walmart. It was evident it was not a real gun. He was unarmed.
I can't breathe.
Eric Garner, 43. He was choked to death.
I can't breathe.
I can't breathe. Victor White, 22, Iberia, LA, March 22nd. He was placed in a chokehold unto death as well.
No justice, no peace.
Mackenzie Cochran, 25, Southfield, Michigan, January 28, 2014. Position, compression, asphyxia, died in a chokehold, unarmed. Jordan Baker, 26, Houston, Texas, January 16, 2014. An off-duty police thought Baker fit the description of a robbery suspect shot in the back, unarmed. Miriam Carver, 34, Washington, D.C., October 3rd, 2013. While attempting a U-turn around the White House, she ran into a barricade. She was shot several times by multiple police, unarmed. Carlos Alexia, 43, New York, August 15, 2013, died of a heart attack after police raided his home looking for someone who stole a cell phone, unarmed.
No justice, no peace.
Larry Eugene Jackson, 32, Austin, Texas, July 26, 2013, fatally shot during the scuffle. He ran. When is it right to shoot a man in the back? Unarmed. This stuff fight back. Keanu Gray, 16, New York, March 9, 2013. Gray pointed a toy revolver at a police. What a mistake. But he was unarmed. Melissa Williams, 30, and Timothy Russell, 43, in Cleveland, Ohio, November 29, 2012, 137 shots. No weapon was found.
It's that
unarmed. The list is over 200 and so names, just for 2 years. Tamir Rice, unarmed. Chantel Davis, 23, New York, unarmed. Timon Robinson. Ferguson, 18, Atlanta, Georgia, unarmed. Rakia Board, 22, Chicago, Illinois, unarmed. Sharice Francis, 30, New York City, March 15, 2012, unarmed. Wendell Allen, 20, New Orleans, LA, March 7th, unarmed. Nehemiah Diller, 29, Gainesville, Florida, March 5th, 2012, unarmed. Raymond Allen, 34, Galveston, Texas, February 22nd, unarmed. Ramoni Graham, 18, New York, unarmed. Kenneth Chamberlain, 68, White Plains, New York, unarmed. The list goes on and on and on for the fallen. What will we do to stop the killings?
I got my hands on my head. Please don't shoot me dead.
We're young, we're strong, we're marching all night long. Thank you. So this happening, the sheer weight of it demands some sort of action. It demands dialogue. Something that we have to consider. It demands outlets through arts, demands marching through the streets, demands putting pressure on the institutions that systemically are broken. We're convinced of this. We have students here who really know this and get this, and are young and want to do something about it. And with their talents today, showed you part of it. And there's some students here who have talents to use verse. There's some students here who have talents to use song. There's some students here who can administer and do a spreadsheet better than anything in the catalog, document this. We need all this. We need all this, and we need to hear these voices too. The third demonstration, everybody sat down. We set up chairs at the student center, and I can ask people, you can come back to your seat. We had this forum, we had people come in and talk. But at the invitation, we had some poetry. Everybody say, King.
Alexander's new gym prologue, buying this jail cell. I'm the Scotland is, and I am Marco, and Mecca, I am also a runner. I am here, I feel Scott, to pop a gunshot. I am Biggie Small, and a booty sweater. Only if you knew me better. Only if you knew me better. Only if I knew me better. I am a scorpion. Craving for skills, everyone's almost in the stomach of Trey Vibe, Martin, I am the big black emphasis steel. On the mouth of Emmett Till, and I don't even know how to seal. I am the bullet of humiliation. And check this out, the back of the unarmed handcuff Oscar Grant at Fruit Bell Station. Face down, ass up. That's the way we like to fuck these black kids up. Because I am the modern day king.
Yes.
Sing this song. I want you to sing along with me. Can we do that?
Yes.
Can we do that?
Yes.
I will sing one line and you repeat it.
Woke up this morning.
Woke up this morning.
With my mind on.
CSU, the me and you, expand our minds and prove these times we have certain rights here as Americans.
don't, take a listen to this. Educationally and socially, we strive for elevation in a segregated country using white intimidation. For thousands of years, we had time to reflect. Black people must now get full effect. English 101, Math 204, and sunny Boston upon the shore. 200 brothers detained by the score. Not as a result of their own doing, but a white man who was deviant pursuing. You see, it's not a crime to say a nigga did it. So a Boston DA took the ball and ran with it. We're not asking you for your pity, not in Cleveland, not in any metropolitan city. We just want to give you the facts and put the freedom chain back on its tracks, because Harriet's journey is about to be lost, and you won't let that happen in any cause. Because my mother and my father put an effort forth so I could cross the river and come to the north. The beauty of our people has been noted throughout time, as long as our hands and mouths moved in rhyme. We often spoke of pain and God's glory. We weren't fictional, but factual, telling our story. You speak of light eyes, light skin, and light hair. Listen up, my people. You had better beware. When the powers that we call rank and file, our place won't be with them. It's somewhere on the Nile. Now, that's not a problem. That's the way it should be. We've been warped by images on TV. Barrett, Christie, and don't forget, Cher, to be beautiful, you must have blue eyes and blonde hair. But the women of color, of every hue, oil satin their skin and bust out their dew. Gone are the days of skin light and carmine. Turn off the hot curls and show the true brain. Now, don't get me wrong, you had texture, we won't debate, but don't abandon your culture because your hair is straight. The beauty is in knowing who we are and aiding our people near and far. Again, the name of this rhyme is The Climate is Right. It is the air we breathe both day and night. We thought we had found opportunity, but were met by the loss of our legacy. Without unity, there's no community. Without monogamy, there's no family. No moral sense of community in a society who thinks oftenly of the first person in the form of me. God created us all equally. There's no big deal in us being free. These are the facts of life for you and me. My last line is peace be unto you, peace.
Close the ring now. Thank you, everybody, for coming.